Got it. What fire wolf wouldn't go for a nice soup bone?
Don't touch it, man. It still looks really hot. Firebone soup must stay hot for a long time.
Little firewolf, you want this bone? If you want it, you gotta follow me, all right?
I think that's gonna work, man. But follow us now. He really wants that bone.
He's following us now. Firewolf, you want the bone? Go get it! Good boy!
That worked great! And there's no place a firewolf is happier than in a fire.
Yup, it's getting warmer already. We've still got stuff to do. Let's get going.
So I told Flambo, if you won't give us your coal so we can be all warm, you're going in the slammer.
Nice. Maybe a few days of liver and onions will make him want to share with us. Hey, you got the key? Of course I do. Hey, we've got company.
That's right. And we're going to take that key and break our friend Flambo out of your rotten jail.
Yeah, I'd like to see you try. Come on, we can take these guys.
Whoa! Yes! Oh! Yeah! Duh!
And this treasure haul leaves butts to be desired.
Yeah, I'm scronk the math out. We totally own those guys if we tried again.
All right, enough! That shrimp Flambo ain't worth taking a beating like this. You want the key? Take it! I'm out of here!
Yeah, you'd better run!
Could have saved us a lot of fighting if they had just given us the dungeon key in the first place.
Flambo, you're a free man. Fire guy.
And nice and warm, too. Those guys are the best. As promised, two flame shields coming up.
Shutera Mesisa, Malakani Porta.
There, you should be good to go inside the core now.
Is the spitting part really necessary?
Nah, that part's just for fun. Thanks for springing me, guys. I'm gonna go hang out someplace warm till you fixes things. Later!
Wonder what that is. Some kind of machine, I guess.
What the? It's starting!
Whoa! What is that thing he's holding?
Whatever it is, it's spewing water everywhere. Guess now we know what's causing all the fires to go out.
Help! Somebody help! Starchy can't control this crazy water gizmo!
We have to get Starchy so we can grab that thing and shut it down. But how?
Starchy's getting really dizzy!
That's not doing anything. Must be another switch somewhere.
Starchy needs help! I can't shut...
Check it out! That made the bridge work!
Starchy's getting really dizzy!
That's not working.
One of us is gonna have to get inside there before we can fiddle with the switch. That might work if we were, you know, on the other side of the glass.
Starchy needs help!
No point in doing that. I think the switch in that glass room needs to be pressed at the same time.
Starchy's getting really dizzy! Starchy needs help! I can't shut this goddamn thing off! Starchy's getting really dizzy!
Let's see what this lever does.
Hey, let me do this one.
Sure, one of them.
Thanks. I don't want you having all the fun.
Whoa! Are you having fun yet?
Ha ha, very funny. Just get me out of here, will you?
Starchy needs help. I can't shut this goddamn thing off.
Well, at least we have a way to use that pressure switch now.
All right. I'll just sit on that pressure plate and see what happens.
All that trouble just to extend a bridge. What kind of donk has designed this place? Algebraic! Sweet!
What'd we ever do to these guys to make them mad?
Ha ha!
To turn that thing off.
Oh, off switch.
Well, Color Starchy embarrassed. Thanks for your help, Finn and Jake. Starchy thought he was a goner.
No problem, man. It's what we do. If you're not too dizzy, we need to ask you some questions.
Sure, Starchy's got nothing to hide.
What is this thing?
It's called the Wet Willy. It's a magic artifact, used to belong to Billy, the greatest warrior ever. A hero of renown, he slayed an evil ocean, he cast the Lich King down.
Yeah, we know how the song goes.
Why do you have this thing?
Starchy wanted to visit his old buddy Cinnamon Bun, but it's really hot in the Fire Kingdom. It makes my crust extra crispy. So I needed something to cool down the fire. Guess it got kind of out of control.
Where did you find this thing?
I bought it at a yard sale. Pretty much everything from Billy's cave is up for sale. If you hurry, you might still be able to get some stuff. But it's going fast. Oh, the prices are great.
Thanks for the info, Starchy. I think we're going to hold on to the Wet Willy, though. It's way too dangerous, especially in the Fire Kingdom.
We saw Flambeau a while back. You should track him down while it's cool and get him to cast Flame Shield on you if you're gonna stay here.
No, thanks. Starchy is out of here. He's had enough of the Fire Kingdom for one day. I'll visit Cinnamon Bun some other time. Thanks again.
Dude, I can't believe somebody's selling all of Billy's stuff.
Yeah, we better go to Billy's cave and see what's up. Jake, what the flip is going on here?
Looks like somebody's having a yard sale in front of Billy's cave.
This is all of Billy's stuff. And most of these things are just as dangerous as the Wet Willy. We need to find out who's selling these artifacts and get them to stop.
There's Marceline. Maybe she knows what's going on.
Hi, Sonny. What brings you here?
Oh, hey. I'm just looking for rare artifacts. I'm a collector.
Well, Billy's cave is full of them. But how did you find the place?
My lantern. The lantern of infinite treasures. It's kind of a compass that sees rare stuff that leads me to it.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I guess it is. Well, see you later.
Later! It's one of those Fez hats. I wonder if this thing is magical too. Billy's Magical Boombox. Too bad it doesn't play records.
Hey, Finn and Jake! You here to shop for cheap magic stuff?
Guess this guy's not for sale.
Hey guys, what's up?
We were going to ask you the same thing, Marceline. What's going on here?
What does it look like? It's a yard sale.
Who's having the yard sale?
I am. I used to live here before I lent the place to Billy. Now that he's gone, I figured I should clean it out so somebody else could use it.
You sure have lived in a lot of different places, Marceline.
What can I say? I'm into real estate.
Do you know what all this stuff is?
Yeah, a bunch of old magic junk. Billy's cave was full of it. He sure did pile up a lot of stuff over the years.
Do you recognize this thing? It's called the Wet Willy.
Well, I didn't know what it was called, but I do recognize it. I sold it to Starchy. He gave me, 4 gallons of red paint for it. You know how much I love red.
How many of these things have you sold so far?
A bunch. Business has been good. People love magic stuff.
Marceline, you have to stop selling this stuff. It's really dangerous. Starchy almost put out all the fires in the Fire Kingdom when he lost control of the Wet Willy. Who knows what some of these other things could do in the wrong hands?
Oh, relax, Finn. You worry too much. Most magic stuff is pretty harmless. It's not like there's a bunch of transmutation and teleportation potions or anything.
Hey, Finn! Hey, Jake! Marceline! How much for this pot?
Oh, wow. Guess there were some transmutation potions.
Jake! Ah, you goody goody!
And teleportation potions. My bad.
Miss me!
Dude, we got tons of loot. Doesn't get much better than that. Dude, where are we? And how do we get here?
That potion the gnome threw must have transported us here. We must be somewhere really deep inside Billy's cave.
Must be some kind of throne room. But it looks like there's a bunch of stuff missing.
Yeah, maybe we can find the missing pieces while we look for an exit. That's not working. I should leave the staff here. It looks nice.
Quit messing with that.
That won't work. Nah, I don't think so. That's stuck in there pretty tight. Think so. Wonder if that guy was supposed to be guarding all this treasure. That's some creepy architecture, man. I'm gonna leave the wand there. I don't need to take it. Looks like those hands used to be holding up something. Looks like there might have been something diamond-shaped in that empty holder. Looks like that skeleton was holding something. Like maybe a wand. But it's missing some fingers. It's a staff with a gem at the top. Being held by creepy hands. That's some creepy architecture, man.
Dude, we got tons of loot. Doesn't get much better than that.
Look, Jake, there's a gem up there. We have to find a way to get to it. Why would I do that? Check it out. It looks like that dragon used to be holding something. The wand is stuck under the dragon's tongue. I can't get it out. Looks like there's something in the dragon's mouth. Sure is a lot of gold in here. Billy was not hurting for dosh. I can never pass up free chewing gum.
Yeah, I guess you could probably use that clasp to hold something in place. Don't know what, but hey, you never know.
Jake could probably help me with this. It's one of those old explodey things. They're all over the place. It's not doing anything.
It's like those pressure switches we keep seeing, only it's missing the flat piece.
Hey, you never know when you might need the leg bone of a giant demon spider thing.
Yeah, what the heck? Not like he needed the dagger anymore.
Spear. Like the ones the banana guards carry, only bigger.
Not gonna work.
That won't work.
That ain't working, dude.
Nah, I don't think so.
That did exactly nothing.
The leg bone is kind of staff-like, but it doesn't quite look like the real staff.
Well, that combination ain't working.
Nope. Those things don't combine.
Don't mess with that wand, Finn. It looks like it belongs there.
That's not working.
Give it up, man.
I don't think so.
Not gonna work.
Nah, I don't think so.
Great idea! That clasp isn't exactly like fingers, but it might just hold a wand in place.
Why would I do that?
Dude, those things totally don't go together.
Those things don't work together. The wand is stuck under the dragon's tongue. I can't get it out.
That ain't working, dude.
That won't work.
Quit messing with that.
That's not working. Nope, it won't budge. Nah, I don't think so.
That did exactly nothing.
Hey, a happy little snail. Hey, Jake, this gem kind of looks like the one in that staff next to the throne.
Hey! It's sort of like that staff we saw back in the throne room.
I'd break the staff trying to pry up the rock. Why would I do that?
Not gonna work.
I don't think so.
That's a good prying dagger.
That won't work. The red gem will definitely not fit in his hand.
Give it up, man. Secret doors don't open that way. There's gotta be a switch or something.
There! Now it should work like the other switch.
I'll hold this switch down for you, Finn. Check it out! Secret doors!
Mathematical!
Cool!
That's about as close to the real staff as we're gonna get. I'm gonna leave the wand there. I don't need to take it.
That ain't working, dude. Yeah, no way that the green gem goes in there.
Yeah, this one's the right shape, but it won't stay in the socket. Old gum. Is there nothing it can't do? That should make the green gem sticky enough not to fall out. There. That'll make the red gem sticky enough to stay in there.
Perfect fit, dude. Good job, Finn. That gem's not going anywhere.
Nah, I don't think so.
Quit messing with that.
I don't think so. That is one big maze.
With all the trouble we've had with artifacts from this place, the gold is probably cursed. Best leave it. What were you thinking trying to combine those?
Why would I do that? The wand is stuck under the dragon's tongue. I can't get it out.
I'm thinking we probably shouldn't mess with that.
Got it. Probably should put it back at some point, though.
That did exactly nothing.
Yeah, that gum is just what I needed. That'll hold the orange gem in the socket. That's not working.
Check it out. The dragon's sticking his tongue out at us. That's a pretty nice wand. Bet that'll come in handy.
Algebraic!
Nice!
Totally worked! The clasp is holding the wand in the skeleton's hand.
Don't take the staff down, Finn. Those hands might grab something else if you take the staff away.
I should leave the staff here. It looks nice. That won't work.
It up, man.
That's the empty hole for that gem I took.
Don't mess with that wand, Finn. It looks like it belongs there. I've heard of buried treasure, but never buried in treasure. Gold usually brightens up a room. Gold skulls? Not so much. Yep, that's got it. The orange gem is back where it belongs.
Finn, Jake, where have you guys been? I was getting kind of worried.
Long story. Marceline, please tell me you stopped selling Billy's stuff.
I still have a few things to track down, but there's one thing I can't find. The sword that opens and closes Billy's cave. I sold it to Cinnamon Bun, but I can't find him anywhere.
Oh, that should be easy to get back. That sword comes to you when you say its name.
What's its name?
Watch this. It's really cool. Its name is... No Tongue!
That's weird. That always worked for Billy.
The problem is that swords with retrieval spells only return to their rightful owner. Since I sold the sword to Cinnamon Bun, it will only come when he calls it.
Oh, well, I guess we'll have to find Cinnamon Bun then. Where do you figure he is?
He lives in the Fire Kingdom now. Guess that's as good a place to start as any.
Good luck, guys. I'm really sorry I caused so much trouble. Bring back the sword and I'll lock everything back inside Billy's cave where it belongs.
Will do. Come on, Jake. Guess we're heading back to Flame Princess. The Fire Kingdom.
I'm on duty. Please don't bother me. Don't touch me.
Nice. Like I always say, you can never have too much charcoal. Actually, I don't think I've ever said that.
No way I could ever reach the bottom of that. That doesn't seem safe. Why would I want to fill the crevice with water?
Quit poking me! Don't touch me! Quit poking me!
Don't touch it, man. It still looks really hot. Firebone soup must stay hot for a long time.
Cinnamon Bun! I'm glad we found you. We need to talk.
Sorry, Finn. I'm really busy. I don't have much time to talk right now.
We'll be quick. Did you buy a sword from Marceline?
Yeah, and I really hate it. Thought it would make me happy. But it's only caused me a lot of grief.
We need to get that sword, Cinnamon Bun. Where is it?
It's around here somewhere. Kinda goes wandering around. But I don't have time to look for it now. I'm busy making soup for Flame Princess. One of the Flame Guards was making it for her earlier in the kitchen. He blew up the soup and destroyed the kitchen. Now I gotta make a new pot! Can't believe that guy screwed it up so bad.
Yeah, good help is hard to find.
Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, I'll help you guys as soon as I'm done. I just need a couple more things.
Jake and me will help you out, CB. Do you have a list of what you need?
Sure.
You need charcoal?
Yeah, this fire's not hot enough. There should be a pile around here somewhere.
We'll get you some charcoal then. Anything else? Peppers? What? The soup needs more spice?
Yeah. Somebody used the last bottle of our ultra-spicy hot sauce, so I'll have to use peppers instead. But somebody took those. If you could track them down and bring me some, that'd be great.
Super spiced peppers coming up. What else?
That's all. Thanks for helping me out, guys.
No problem. Come on, Jake. The sooner we bring back some charcoal and peppers, the sooner we can find out where that sword is.
Whoa, dude! Check out this thing!
Yeah, wow! How come this didn't seem important the last time we were in the hallway?
What do you think it does?
That, I guess.
Uh-huh. Hey, there's Flambeau! He's got a big pile of hot peppers!
Hey, Flambeau! How about giving us some of those peppers? Cinnamon Bun needs them for the soup he's making for Flame Princess.
No way! These peppers are mine, fair and square. I ain't giving them up.
Man, why can't stuff ever be easy?
Yeah, right? We gotta find a way to get those peppers from him. There, that cooled it down. The fuel blobs will pass right by it now. There, that cooled it down. The fuel blobs will pass right by it now. Whoa! Now it's super hot! When a blob hits a flame, it explodes! Cool! Fire in the hole! What the? That ain't fair!
Well, that's one way to get the peppers, I guess.
It would have been easier if Flambeau had just given them to us. Oh, well. Cool!
Cool!
I'm trying to concentrate. Please, just bring me the stuff I need. Good job, Finn and Jake. The fire's plenty hot to boil the soup now. Once we add the peppers, the soup will be ready to simmer. Thanks, Finn and Jake. The fire's going great. There should be just enough peppers in there to make Flame Princess feel better. I'll set aside a little to taste and seal the pot to simmer.
Cinnamon Bun, now that we've helped you, can we...
Not until I taste the soup, Finn. Here goes. Oh, ow! This soup is burning my taste buds! Ow! Oh, I wish I had no tongue!
Yeah!
What the flip was that?
That was the stupid thorn you were looking for! I told you it causes no tongue but grief! Oh no! The thorn knocked the soup pot across the room! Could you guys go get it so I can put it back on the fire?
Yeah, sure.
You guys have got to get that pot of soup back for me!
Man, the sword knocked the pot up onto the ledge where we got the charcoal. I don't think so. Nah, I don't think so. It's too far to reach.
Just use the stairs, guys. That's why we built them in the first place.
Nice job. There's still one plank missing.
Nope, you can't reach it.
It's still missing a plank.
You see that? That crazy sword flew through here with a pot of soup and busted the steps! Don't touch me! Quit poking me!
Hardly any fire at all in this one. Fuel blobs pass right by it.
No way, man. I'm not going in there. Find some other way to get the plank. That plank's way down there, dude. Can't reach it. Good thinking, Finn. The plank is floating right to the top.
And good as new. Yeah!
Awesome. Great. Let's get the soup back to the fire for cinnamon bun.
Thanks! You guys are the best!
Glad we can help. Now listen, you have got to give that sword back before it causes more damage or somebody gets hurt.
You can have it. I don't want it anymore.
It has to be official. You have to give Finn the bill of sale so he's the official owner of the sword. Otherwise, he can't call it to him.
Okay, here's the bill of sale. No thong is yours.
It must have worked. It didn't come flying when CB said its name.
Awesome. I guess I'll just call it then. No t-
Hang on! Remember, Billy used to catch the sword with the gauntlet of the hero. If you try it barehanded, you might lose a finger. Or, you know, an arm. You hated it last time that happened.
Yeah, that was no fun. But the gauntlet of the hero was destroyed by the lich. Where else can we find a nice, sturdy glove to catch the sword with?
Hey, how about all those weird catcher's mitts that Lemongrab has in his castle? Maybe we could, borrow one?
Yeah, that's a great idea. Let's head over to Castle Lemongrab.
Okay, but we better be careful. Lemongrab's probably still mad about the pranks and being electrocuted, stuff like that.
Yeah, good thinking. It's definitely worth noting. Aw, come on. That wasn't even close to no tongue.
Ugh, would somebody please get that sword out of my kingdom?
On it, princess. Come on, Jake, let's go.
You! Why have you returned to Castle Lemongrab?
Listen, man, we're really sorry about what happened when we were here before. Our behavior was...
Unacceptable?
Yeah, totally.
Yes, your pranks made me quite angry. And you left that magic person in my reconditioning chamber. Even I find him to be most unpleasant. Have you come to take him away? I hope.
No, sorry. Actually, we came to ask if we could use something.
Yeah, one of those catcher's mitts you have in all your display rooms. We won't take it out of the display, and we only need it for a few minutes.
my catcher's mitts are very important to me and have great value in my lemon heart. But perhaps I can allow it.
Aw, come on, Lemon Grab. You wouldn't be asking if it wasn't really important. Wait, what?
Yes, you may use one of my precious mitts.
Awesome, thanks. We'll just go and...
If you can bypass my new defenses, I have set up a security device that should eliminate all pranking in the future. If you can find a way past it, you may have the mitt you seek.
Knew there had to be a catch.
You got a deal. Where do we start?
Begin in the hallway, where you first began your last tormenting of me. But do not dare to hope, for you will find that your attempts to break through are futile. Now, go!
I didn't think he'd just let us borrow one of his catcher's mitts. All the doors have been changed.
Yeah, they've got lights over them. And there's a bunch of poles with lemons on them in the hall.
That must be the security system Lemon Grab was talking about. Wonder how it works.
He said it was really complicated. Sure hope we can figure it out. If we don't, we'll never get that catcher's mitt. I don't think that's gonna make the lemon on the pole change color.
That won't work. That lemon is way too dirty to clean off with my hand.
I don't think that's gonna make the lemon on the pole change color.
The door's locked. Guess that's why the big light is red? Door's locked. Guess that's why the big light is red? All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pole. All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pole. There! Now it looks like the dark-colored lemon poles. There! Now it looks like the dark-colored lemon poles. Why would I do that? All right, guess I'll try calling the sword. Here goes no tongue!
The catcher's mitt must be a lot bouncier than the gauntlet of the hero. We're gonna have to find some way to make the sword stick to the mitt.
Looks like the dark-colored lemon poles.
Nice work, Finn. Now that lemon pole is light-covered. Yeah, that'll work. Now that one looks just like the dark-colored lemon poles.
All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pole.
Nice thought, but the lemon candy isn't sticky enough to stop the sword. Maybe if it was chewed up, but it's way too sour for us to chew.
All right, guess I'll try calling the sword. Here goes no tongue!
The catcher's mitt must be a lot bouncier than the gauntlet of the hero. We're gonna have to find some way to make the sword stick to the mitt.
You are wasting time! If you do not get past my lemon defenses, you will not find the mitt you seek!
Hey, Lemon Grab, we found a bunch of lemon candy. Want some?
Yes! I love lemon candy! Yes, so sour! Sour is so much better than spicy! Spicy is unacceptable!
Hey, what do you think about one more prank, for old time's sake? Maybe spice things up a little.
Yeah, I bet we can come up with something good!
Lemon Johns! Ooh! Yes! Yes!
Red light means locked, I guess. Yeah, that'll work. Now that one looks just like the dark-colored lemon poles.
All clean! Now it's a light-colored lemon pole.
Wasting time! If you do not get past my lemon defenses, you will not find the mitt you seek!
What were you thinking trying to combine those? Lemon Grab will totally flip if we give him some spicy Lemon John candies.
Hey, we still got plenty lemon candy left. Want some more?
Yes! Sour, non-spicy lemon candy is my favorite of all treats!
This is gonna be great!
Wonderful! This is spicy! Too spicy! You have spice pranked me again! I will not stand for this! It is unacceptable! I am in need of water! I am going! Do not try to follow me and console me in any way!
Yeah, no worries on that front.
Algebraic!
Yeah! Man, that wad of chewed lemon johns would stick to pretty much anything.
There! Now it looks like the dark-colored lemon poles.
Nice work, Finn. Now that lemon pole is light-covered. Good thinking. The sword won't bounce off the mitt now.
Okay, let me try calling the sword again. No tongue!
Hey, it worked! Let's grab that stupid sword and get out of here.
Mathematical! Sweet!
Glad that's over. Let's head back to Billy's cave and put that sword where it belongs.
Finn, Jake, you're back. Did you get Billy's sword?
Yeah, but you wouldn't believe what we had to go through to get it.
Nah, I was filling Marceline in on what you did. Glad it all turned out. And no hard feelings for taking all my peppers. We can even that score at some later date.
Thanks. Marceline, how about you? Any problems tracking down all the artifacts and putting them back in Billy's cave?
No problems worth mentioning. Everything's back. We should be fine once we seal up the cave.
Then what are we waiting for? I guess nothing. Hey, where are you going? Man, that is super annoying.
Yeah, and it's gonna be a problem. The cave won't stay sealed if the sword keeps flying away to its owner.
What can we do? I wish there was a way to make Billy the rightful owner again.
That's it! Good thinking. If you destroy the bill of sale, the sword reverts to its original owner.
Great! Let's do it! That's not working. There's no point in putting the sword in the crack until the bill of sale is destroyed. Nope, those things don't combine.
No way! I don't want to own that crazy sword.
Nah, I don't think so.
That ain't working, dude.
That's the crack that Billy's sword goes in. Charcoal. Always a good first step to building a fire. Seems like the right idea, but the wrong time for it. Guess we're ready to light the fire now. Hey, Flambo! Want the rest of your peppers back?
Oh, there's some left? Yeah, sure. Hey, yours are great.
All right. Bye-bye, Bill of Sale.
Yeah! Now let's seal up Billy's cave so we can head home. Okay, time to close up Billy's cave again. Ugh.
Ugh. Now all of Billy's stuff is safely locked away where nobody will get to it. At least for now.
Thanks, guys. Sorry I caused so much trouble.
It's okay. Just no more yard sales!
Are you guys telling me what I can and can't do?
No. Marceline, you can totally do whatever you want. We would never...
After all these years, you guys are still easy targets. See ya!
Sheesh! I think I've had enough for today. Let's head home.
You said it, buddy. I could use a little downtime. This investigation stuff is hard work.
Perfect! That's exactly what Bimo needed. There! Finn, Jake, I have fixed the record player. Yay, Bimo!
Whoa, nice job, Bimo. That's even better than the old one.
Yeah, that's awesome. What say we do a little dancing to celebrate our first four successful investigations?
That's a great idea. I think we should start by playing my favorite record, the one Mom and Dad used to play for me. Where'd you put it, Bimo?
I have it right here, Finn. Don't worry, I kept it very safe. And I cleaned it up just for you!
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's spin that puppy!
Here we go! Yay! Dance party!
There is actually music on your favorite record, right?
Bimo, when you cleaned the record, what did you do?
I noticed that the record was very bumpy, so I fixed it with sandpaper. It's now smooth as a Bimo's bottom. Yay, Bimo!
You did what?
BMO! The bumpy parts are what hold all the music and stuff! Without those, the record won't play!
Oh no! BMO has really messed things up! Oh, I'm sorry, Finn.
That's okay, BMO. You were only trying to help. But man, what are we gonna do, Jake? That record was a reminder of how Mom and Dad raised me after they found me in the woods. I love that record.
Don't worry, buddy. We'll think of some...
Jake, I don't know if I can concentrate on another case right now.
I don't know, man. Check this out.
Investigators desperate to fix Finn's favorite record. That's weirdly specific.
Yeah, but it must mean there's a way to fix the record. What should we do first?
Well, let's start by taking the record to Marceline. She helped us the last time we had a musical problem. Maybe she knows what we have to do to fix it. Look! There's a new case available on the ticker site. Investigators desperate to fix Finn's favorite record. Yeah, you got that right. Marceline, we've got another musical problem and we need your help.
Oh no, Magic Man's not gonna make us dance again, is he? Because that got old really fast.
No, it's way worse. BMO wrecked my favorite record. He sanded off all the grooves and now it won't play.
Is that all? That's no problem, you can fix that. You just have to get your groove back, so to speak.
How do I do that?
Well, it's not easy, but I can help. First, you're gonna have to get your hands on some pretty rare equipment. Here's a list of what you need.
The epic microphone of crooning? Is that some kind of special microphone?
Yes. It's charged with powerful magical energy. It senses the emotions of whoever's making the recording and transforms the performance into whatever epic music you can imagine.
Cables of insulation? You mean we need special cables to make this work?
To make a perfect recreation of Finn's record, we'll be using a lot of magic. A normal cable would just melt. Cables of insulation are magically insulated so that spell energy and music can flow through them together without everything going up in smoke.
A reel-to-reel recorder? Can't we just use the cassette recorder we normally use when we jam out?
Not reel-to-reel, reel-to-reel. It's a rare magical tape recorder. It magically mixes any musical sound into an exact copy of whatever song you're trying to make. No matter what the real music sounds like, the recording is always perfect. With a little work, I can rig it to record the music on a record.
I guess it's shopping time! Where can we get all this stuff?
Well, it's all magic, so you'll have to go to Wizard City.
Marceline, we can't go to Wizard City. They won't let us in like last time. BMO used that ultimate wizard disc thingy to rebuild our record player.
Yeah, the wizard police would just turn us into sticks.
Don't worry, I got you covered. Force Wizard owed me a favor. He never gave me back the potion distiller I lent him. To apologize, he gave me some day pass charms for Wizard City. I'll cast two on you before you leave.
Word. Thanks, Marceline.
No problem. Once you get all the stuff, come back to me and I'll tell you what we need to do next.
Hey, wizards only for... Oh, sorry. I see your day pass enchantments are in order. Move along, have a nice day.
Cool, thanks man! Sure, I guess a broom could come in handy at some point. Nothing interesting on the notice board this time. It's that wizard payphone that we used to order the pizza that other time.
Don't mess with it, Finn. We're not supposed to know that's a secret door. I guess we know where to go if we need to buy a skull.
That awesome pendant can be yours for the low, low price of one wizard coin.
Welcome back, brothers. What kind of magic biz y'all's up to today?
We're making a record, and our friend Marceline said that we need some magical recording equipment. You sell that stuff?
Magical tunes. Nice.
What do you need? We have a list. Marceline said that we need a special magical tape recorder. Do you have one of those?
A reel-to-reel recorder? No, man. I don't carry those. They're really, really rare. But there's gotta be one or two floating around somewhere in town. There are a lot of wizards that are way into awesome audio.
How about a magic microphone? You have one of those?
You're in luck! I just picked up a really sweet one. The epic microphone of crooning. It's top of the line in magic microphones.
Dude, that's the one Marceline said we need. We gotta get that.
Bummer is, it's lost its magical charge. I couldn't in good conscience sell you an uncharged magic microphone.
Well, that kind of works out because we probably don't have enough money to buy one at the moment.
Marceline said we need some kind of special cable to hook everything up. Got any of that?
Nah, that specialized magic audio cable is way too expensive, brah. Truth? Any heavily insulated magical cable can be used instead of actual cable of insulation. That kind of cable is just laying around in Wizard City all over the place. Looks like all I've got that you need is the microphone. Like I said, it ain't charged. And like you said, you don't have enough money to buy it anyway.
Oh man, we really need that microphone. Can't we make some kind of deal?
Well, an uncharged microphone ain't gonna sell anyway, and getting it recharged is a problem. Magic Mike's charge shop got raided by the Wizard Popo yesterday, and all his stuff got seized. I'd ask him to help me out anyway, but you know, he's a stick now.
Yeah, that happens a lot around here.
If I had a magical charger, I could start offering charging services. I'd be the only one in town doing it. We're talking some major wizard coin. Tell you what, if you guys can find me a working magical charger, the epic microphone of crooning, it's yours. I'd even throw in a free charge. What do you say?
I say we're gonna go out and find you a magical charger. Thanks, Ron James. We'll see you soon.
Happy to help. Feel free to browse. I might not have everything you need, but I always encourage impulse buying.
That's a waste of time. Wizard robe. Nice. That lid's stuck tight. I'll never be able to open the sarcophagus thingy barehanded. That won't work. Celine said we needed a special cable for our recording. All I found is an old battery cable. Oh well, I'll take it anyway. I bet this cable will work great for our recording. Funny the amount of useful stuff we found laying around lately. Graffiti cleaner is not in my job description.
I think that battery cable's the only useful thing that was in there. That ain't working, dude.
That's not working. Hey, a happy little snail. Sup, Bufo? What you doing? Selling stuff?
Of course I am! What does it look like? Sorry, I'm under a lot of stress. Please, take a look around and let me know if you have any questions.
So, looks like some kind of tape recorder there.
Better than that. It's a rare reel-to-reel recorder. Best magic recorder there is. Works like it was brand new. It's yours for the low, low price of 50 wizard coins.
Finn, that's just what we need. But there's no way we can afford that.
What about that charger-looking thing? What's the story on that?
That is a State of the Dark Arts magical item charger. You can recharge wands, magic swords, anything that runs on magic. It's a fixer-upper, so I could probably let it go for a mere 30 wizard coins.
It's kind of pricey for a piece of junk that doesn't work.
How about magical cables? Got any of those?
Sorry, afraid not.
We're in the market for a special microphone. The epic microphone of crooning. Do you have one?
Oh, I'm sorry. I did have one, but I sold it to Ron James earlier today. You snooze, you lose.
Yeah, so we're interested in your stuff, but we're sort of, kind of...
Broke. We're pretty much doshed out.
I see. Well, I'm always willing to negotiate a fair price, but I can't come down too much. We all need money.
Yeah, about that. Why does a super powerful wizard like you need to sell junk for extra scratch?
I lost my secret society pendant. Until I can afford to replace it, I am banished from the secret society of wizards.
Man, that stinks. Well, if we come up with some money or something, Jake and me would be happy to help you out and buy your stuff.
Okay, but the merchandise is moving fast. You better act quickly. Oh, who am I kidding? I'll be here whenever you come back. You think I'd trade one of my quality magic items for a broom? Please. No thanks. I don't have any use for a battery cable. You'll probably want to hang on to that in case you decide to buy this sweet reel-to-reel recorder. I'm a wizard. I don't need a sword.
Yeah, a crowbar always comes in handy, but I can't just take it. I don't think so.
If you're gonna take that crowbar, really should put something in its place. Somebody's gonna notice.
You got a crowbar, and the sign makes sense now. Win-win.
Man, I just hope there's not a body in there.
It's a battery for... something. Hope it's not a dead battery. Could be because, you know, it's in a coffin.
That battery isn't a fair trade for anything I've got here.
Howdy.
Wizards are... Oh, never mind. Hi.
It's that wizard payphone that we used to order the pizza that other time.
I'd be happy to sell you guys that pendant. That'll be one wizard coin, cash money.
That is not helping at all.
No reason to do that.
You really don't need to do that.
Hey, quit messing with my posh bottles!
Great prices, but we don't need any of this stuff.
Hey, what's up, Sonny?
Oh, hey. Good to see you guys again. You guys are wizards?
Nah, we got a day pass spell from our friend Marceline. You buy anything good from Ron James?
Nah, I haven't really found anything interesting. You?
We're just shopping for recording equipment.
Magical recording equipment.
Oh, well, good luck with that. See you guys later. Hey.
Don't mess with it, Finn. We're not supposed to know that's a secret door.
Yeah, I'll just take that coin. Finders keepers.
I'd be happy to sell you guys that pendant. That'll be one wizard coin, cash money.
Congratulations, bros! You just bought yourselves a really nice pendant of some kind. Enjoy!
Wonder if this pendant is like the one Bufo was saving for. So, think we could do a trade for this?
What the? My secret society pendant! You found it!
So, can we maybe trade the pendant for...
Take it! Take all of this junk! It's yours! I've gotta go! Guys, I have my pendant! Don't start the next meeting without me!
Man, that is one happy wizard.
Yeah, and he gave us stuff! Algebraic!
Nice!
The only thing better than cool stuff? Is free cool stuff!
Looks like the charger needs to have a battery connected to it. Let's get it working and take it back to Ron James's shop.
Sorry, guys. I can't accept this charger. It's missing some of its parts. If you can fix it, I'd be happy to make a trade for the epic microphone of crooning.
That battery definitely fits, but we need to plug it into the charger somehow. There! The magical charger thing is as good as new.
You found a working magical charger! Powerful one, too, yo! It charged the epic microphone of crooning without even attaching it! Here's your microphone, all charged and ready to go. Thanks, guys!
Epic microphone of crooning, reel-to-reel recorder, and some super insulated magic cable. I think we got everything we need, Jake.
Awesome, dude. We'll get that record of yours fixed in no time. Let's take everything back to Marceline's house and find out what we have to do next.
All right, Marceline, we got all the magic recording equipment you asked for. Are we ready to start fixing my record now?
No, silly. We've still got a long way to go. We've got the hardware we need, but we still need to put together a band to jam out and make the music.
But we don't know any bands. Not any good ones, anyway.
That's one of the reasons we're using magical recording equipment, Jake. It makes anything sound good. There are plenty of crappy bands out there who only avoid sounding like total butt through the magic of awesome recording equipment.
Okay. Who should we get to be in the band?
Well, I'll play bass, of course, because I'm awesome at it. We just need to figure out what other sounds we need and which four people we're going to recruit.
We're going to need some high-end sound, you know, as a counterpoint to your tasty bass licks.
Yeah, definitely. How about Lemon Grub? That sword thing of his makes a sound that is about as high-end as you can get. It's not really an instrument, but I think it'll work.
Lemon Grab doesn't play well with others, even in the best times. Which these are not. Last time we were at his castle, there was, an incident.
Several, if we're being honest.
You need to find some way to get him to agree to join us, guys. I just know that sword sound is perfect for the mix.
We'll do what we can. Well, we're definitely going to need drums.
Totally. That should be easy. Simon is a wicked good drummer. Plus, he has his own drum kit.
That will be easy. Ice King always wants to do stuff with Jake and me.
Yeah, but remember, last time we saw him, we kind of put him in a super depressed mood. Kind of on purpose.
Well, I guess you guys will have to find a way to deal with that before you can get him to join.
Okay, what's next on the list?
Whoa. Slow down, Finn. You've already got your work cut out for you. Why don't you go ahead and recruit Simon and Lemon Grab for now? When you're done, come back here and we'll figure out who's next.
Sounds like a plan. Come on, Jake. First stop, the Ice Kingdom. Hey, Ice King. What's up?
Oh, hey, guys.
Look, we just want to apologize.
Apologize? Why? You weren't the ones who wrecked my crib. That was Lumpy Space Princess.
Huh? Oh, the mess. We thought you might still be depressed because of the whole princess dumping you and us messing with you about a thing.
You're gonna have to be more specific, Jake. That princess dumping me, people making fun of me stuff is kind of an everyday thing for me. Kind of all runs together after a while.
Oh, well, moving on then. So, you're upset because of what LSP did to your place?
Yeah, man, look at it. I might be a lonely, pathetic bachelor, but I got standards. This place is nasty, and half of my cool stuff is all donked up.
So, we're putting together an awesome band, and we thought we'd ask you to be our drummer. What do you say?
Oh, man, that sounds great. But I can't do it, not now. I'm totally out of shape, and my drum kit is wrecked.
Oh, out of shape. What are you talking about? You're, looking buff, man.
Aw, you're just saying that because you're my bro for life. But I'm a mess, man. LSP took a piece from my weight set and I can't work out. My wicked abs have turned into wicked flabs. No way I can play the skins when I'm this out of shape.
What's wrong with your drums?
I have no idea what LSP was doing to them while I was away, but they were super nasty when I got back. They were covered in food and all kinds of stuff. Didn't even know what half of it was. I cleaned them up as best I could, but one of the cymbals is missing. And it's the best one! I could never get my percussion groove on without my favorite cymbal.
We can help you, Ice King. We'll make your weight bench and drums good as new.
Yeah, and if we do, will you join our band?
Sure, totally. I can get back into shape in no time.
All right, Ice King. Your turbros are on the case. I can't lift weights when the pole's missing. Not that I'd want to lift weights anyway.
This recliner is covered in frost. It can't be very comfortable.
Looks like something's frozen into the wall. I'm pretty sure I won't be able to dig through this ice wall with my sword.
Water's still warm, and it doesn't look too dirty.
Nah, I don't think so.
Dude, if you like dirty plates so much, I could stop doing the dishes back at the treehouse.
Hey, check it out! The dirty plate wasn't a symbol of lazy housekeeping. It was an actual symbol! Good as new! Never know when you might need a blowtorch, I guess.
Nah, man, we don't have time to play Ice Ninja right now.
Hey, Gunter, wanna give me your broom? No? Okay, then. That won't work. Snail. I never get tired of looking at Ice King's ninja weapon collection.
Good job fixing the drum kit, dude. Looks good.
Nice job on the drums, guys. They look good as new.
Weird. Who'd freeze a saw into a wall of ice? Up, man.
I don't think so.
Who attacks a penguin just to take a broom? Find a way to distract Gunter or something if you want the broom so bad.
Ice King should really turn that off. He's wasting power.
Combination ain't working.
I'm not sure, but I think he looks at least a little happier now. Hey, Gunter, check it out! A bottle!
Quang.
Traded you the bottle for the broom?
Quang.
That penguin sure loves breaking bottles.
Gunter likes bottles better than brooms anyway.
And now the ninja broom is a wooden pole. Awesome, I guess.
That broomstick will make an okay replacement for the missing bar, I guess. For a while, anyway. Okay, Ice King, your weight bench and drums are fixed. Still want to be in the band?
Do I? Just you try and stop me. But don't really try and stop me, because I want to be part of your thing, whatever it is. I just like being included in things, you know, from time to time.
He's bumming me out, dude.
Okay then. You work out or whatever you need to do, and we'll see you at the treehouse in a few hours.
Roger that. I'll be there. Gunter, bring me my Tubby Day spandex sweats. It's time for a turbo workout. I got flab to burn.
Quack, quack.
Dude, I can't watch that. Let's head over to Castle Lemongrab and figure out how we're going to get him to come and annoy us at our house, too.
Lemongrab isn't here.
Probably just as well. I mean, what are we going to do to convince him to come to the treehouse and be in the band? We're not exactly on friendly terms.
Yeah, I guess the only thing we can do is trick him somehow. You have to think of something that will get him worked up and make him want to come to our place.
I got it! Lemon Hope! We can tell him that Lemon Hope is hiding out at our place! That'll definitely get his attention!
Yeah, but he's never going to believe us. He has trust issues.
What if we showed him Lemon Hope's musical instruments? Playing music was what Lemongrab hated most about Lemon Hope.
Yeah, good idea. Let's look around. Maybe Lemon Hope left an extra harp and flute around here somewhere. And if not, maybe we can make some fake ones that'll trick Lemongrab.
Looks like Lemongrab is rebuilding his reconditioning chamber. Probably started right after we wrecked it.
Yeah, I don't think he knows any other way to control his peeps. Let's look around. Could be something in here we can use. Never know when you might want to make holes in something. I don't think a drill's going to help me remove the switch. Pretty nice screwdriver. I'm sure I'll find a use for it. There. Once again, Lemongrab won't be able to use his reconditioning chamber. Plus, I have a cool-looking switch.
Good thinking. Never know when you'll need a wrench.
Locked. Never hurts to have some extra string handy for craft projects and stuff. It's locked. Those things don't work together. The pipes are loose, but not that loose. I'm going to need a way to loosen them if I want to take them. Sweet! Now I have two iron pipes, a long one and a short one. Why would I do that?
That did exactly nothing.
That's not working.
not gonna work. That combination definitely ain't working. I see where you're going, but it won't look like a harp with the strings just hanging from it. They need to stretch tight.
Nope, those things don't combine.
Nice. It looks just like the frame of Lemon Hope's harp. What were you thinking trying to combine those?
Check it out, Jake. Lemon Grab will totally think this is Lemon Hope's harp. I can't combine those.
Dude, those things totally don't go together.
That won't work.
That ain't working, dude.
Why would I do that?
Quit messing with that.
And now, I have some ripped up strips of cloth. Cool, I guess. That combination definitely doesn't work. I don't think so.
Well, those things can't be combined.
Combination, fail.
What were you thinking trying to combine those? There's no point in looking for Lemon Grab until we have a harp and a flute to show him. Let's look around and see what we can find.
Those strips of cloth almost make it look like Lemon Hope's flute. Still something missing, though.
Whoa! That's what that was missing! That totally looks like Lemon Hope's flute now. Okay, we have a harp and a flute. That ought to convince Lemon Grab that Lemon Hope is hiding out at our place.
Now all we have to do is find Lemon Grab. Let's go check the throne room. He hangs out there a lot. Here we go. Hey, what's up, Lemon Grab? How's it going?
You! You have returned! I am still making repairs on the damage you did last time you were here! Your presence is unwelcome and unacceptable!
Yeah, well, sorry we messed up your castle, Earl. But we have some news that will make you really happy.
Well, if that's even possible, that is.
What is this news of which you speak?
We know where you can find Lemon Hope. He's hanging out at our treehouse, and he totally wants you to stop by and talk.
And I should very much like to talk to him as well. But you have proven yourselves untrustworthy. I would require proof that Lemon Hope is at your house.
You got it. Check it out, Lemon Hope's harp.
The evil, evil harp that caused so much pain to my sensitive lemon ears. It hurts just to look at it.
Here's Lemon Hope's flute. Nobody has a flute quite like this one.
Yes, that appears to be his flute. His harp music offended my lemon sensibilities. However, the flute music was very cacophonous and therefore quite restful. Your evidence is compelling, and I now believe that the fugitive Lemon Hope is being harbored illegally in your home. I must prepare proper punishment for both Lemon Hope and those who would protect him.
That's cool. Hey, wait, what?
Now leave me. I will go now and tune the vibrations of my sound sword to optimum screech. When I have completed this task, I shall come to your tree dwelling and unleash the proper punishment on all who deserve it. I will then return Lemon Hope to his proper place here, in a locked room of my castle.
Okay, later!
Jake, he totally bought it!
Yeah, I can't say I'm too crazy about all that punishment talk, though.
All that matters is that he'll be there waving around that sound sword and making noise, just like we need him to be. We can worry about the rest later. Come on, let's head back to Marceline's and find out who else we need to recruit to finish off the band. Alright, Marceline, Ice King is on the drums, and Lemon Grab is heading to the treehouse with his sound sword.
Probably with the intention of using it on us, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
Cool. Now we just need a keyboard player and a singer.
Hey, how come Princess Bubblegum's hanging around? She looks kind of upset.
Oh, it's something about her clothes or something. For somebody who rules one of the biggest kingdoms in all of Ooh, she gets hung up on the silliest things sometimes. You should talk to her if you're worried about it. I'm not much on the whole fashion thing.
So, where do we get a keyboard and who's going to play it?
We're in luck there. Princess Bubblegum says we can use her science keyboard, no problem. And she's a good musician, but she can't be the one who plays it.
Huh? Why not?
Bonnabelle's inspiration comes from her brain, which is great for science stuff, but not so much for music. Good music comes from the heart. And the best music comes from a broken heart. That's what we're gonna need if we're gonna make your record work again.
Hey, Finn, maybe we should get Flame Princess to play the keyboard. She broke your heart big time.
Huh? What? No! What are you talking about? I'm not... She...
Yeah, sounds like Flame Princess will be perfect. You can never have too much heartbreak in a song.
Okay, fine. I don't even know if Flame Princess knows how to play. Guess we'll find out.
Hey, wait! Why do we need a singer?
It's all about the magical mixing. We just need the right amount and tone of input noise to make the mix work perfectly.
Well, if it's noise we're after, we should definitely get Lumpy Space Princess to sing for us. She's terrible.
Yeah, but she's also mad at us. We messed up her chance to have her own kingdom, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, if you guys can convince the Earl of Lemongrab to join the band, you can convince LSP. She might be grumpy, but there's nothing she likes better than the sound of her own voice. I'm sure you can pull it off.
Okay, Marceline. We'll do our best to get Flame Princess and LSP to join the band. Once they're in, are we ready to fix my record?
Yep. I'll take the equipment over to the treehouse and wait for you there. After everything's set up and everyone gets there, we'll make your record good as new.
Algebraic! Come on, Jake. First stop, the Fire Kingdom.
Maybe we should talk to PB first. I don't want her to be so upset that she won't let us use her science keyboard.
Yeah, I guess you're right. The record can wait until we fix PB's problem. Hey, PB. Marceline said something's up.
Yes, something is definitely up. I sent all of my new outfits off to the dry cleaning kingdom, and they were supposed to come back today. But Magic Man thought it would be fun to intercept my delivery and scatter my clothes all over Ooh.
That explains it. I was wondering why you were dressing so retro here lately.
Oh, man. I was hoping I wouldn't have to deal with Magic Man again for a while.
You don't. He lost interest and went away. And I found most of my stuff. I'm only missing 3 outfits now. Marceline won't help me because she thinks I'm silly to worry about stuff like this.
She does have a point.
Yeah, but if it's important to you, it's important to us. Jake and me will keep an eye out and find your missing outfits, PB.
Thanks, Finn. You're the best.
I think that might be one of PB's missing outfits. Magic Man must have thrown it in the water.
I hope you find Bonnabelle's missing clothes, otherwise we'll never hear the end of it.
It's too far to reach with the sword, and even if I could, I'd rip it.
It's too far, man. We're gonna have to find some other way to fish it out. Glad we've still got a little of that flame shield spell left over from last time we were in the Fire Kingdom. It's almost back up to normal temperature again.
Yeah, it's pretty hot. We shouldn't waste any time. Hi, Flame Princess.
Hey, Finn. What's up?
You sound a little down. What's wrong?
It's nothing. What did you want to talk about?
Well, it's kind of a long story. See, I have this favorite record, and BMO,
we want you to play keyboard in our band. Will you do it?
Really? Me? Well, I did take lessons as a little girl, but I haven't played in a really long time. I doubt I'd be any good. I can't even inspire the people of the Fire Kingdom to follow my leadership. And that's my job.
No way! I bet you'd be awesome!
I don't think so, Finn. Playing keyboards was never anything but a hobby. Sorry, I just know I'd wreck your band like I'm wrecking the Fire Kingdom.
You just got confidence issues, that's all. I bet your people appreciate you way more than you think. You're not a total tyrant like your dad was. No offense.
None taken. My dad is a complete donkus when it comes to ruling. But I don't know.
What if Jake and me prove that your people have confidence in you? Would you join the band then?
I guess so, but how would you prove that?
It'll be easy. What's not to love about you? I mean, your leadership and all.
You just wait here. We'll get back to you. What do you have in mind, Finn?
Thank you notes always feel good. Let's go around and get people to write notes to Flame Princess to say how much they appreciate her. That'll boost her confidence big time.
Sounds like a plan. You're gonna have to find a way to distract the Firewolf before you take that hot coal. Check it out, a snail.
Hey, Flambo! You like having Flame Princess in charge, right?
Sure, things is way better here with her running a joint.
So, how about writing a note to thank her for being an awesome ruler? It'd really help to cheer her up and boost her confidence.
Sure, but I need something from you first.
What do you need?
I used up all my coal when we went through that cooldown last time yous were here. I want to have some more on hand in case things get cold again sometime. Give me some hot coals, and I'll write that note for yous.
Okay, we'll see what we can find.
They're trying to steal our inspiring portrait of Flame Princess! Get them!
We got him, Jake.
Yeah, but I bet we could do better and get more treasure. It's up to you, though.
Jeez, there was no need for all the fighting. I was just gonna borrow it for a while. Check it out! One of PB's missing outfits was nailed to the wall behind the painting.
Good eye, Finn. PB will be happy to get that back, I bet.
You two again! I heard you came back. You're not gonna leave this kitchen until you clean up that mess you made before when you blew up my firebone soup.
I want to disagree, but he's right. It's our mess. We should clean it up.
Don't touch it, man. It still looks really hot. Firebone soup must stay hot for a long time.
Guess it's okay for us to use this mop. Yikes! That is not water.
That's right. Put your back into it.
This stuff mops up surprisingly well.
Yeah, but it's burning the mop down to a stick.
All right. I'm satisfied. Thanks for your cooperation. Flame Bird out.
Oh, yeah, right. Not cool.
One hot coal? I'm gonna need more than that if there's ever another emergency.
Here, boy! Want the stick? Go get it!
Firewolves sure like chasing stuff.
And they're not too bright. I didn't even throw it. Whatevs. He'll be busy for a while trying to find it. Youch! That's one hot lump of coal.
That's what I'm talking about! That much hot coal will keep me warm through anything but a total deep freeze. Here's my thank you note. Hope it helps.
All right!
Sweet!
Hey, Cinnamon Bun, we need your help.
Hey, Finn! Sure, I'll help you. You've helped me and Flame Princess a lot.
Flame Princess is feeling a little down. We're trying to get people to write thank you notes to tell her what a great leader she is. You know, to boost her confidence.
That's a great idea. She has been kind of down, and that makes me sad. But I don't know if I can do that. I can only write when I have inspiration. Otherwise, my words don't come out too good.
Inspiration, huh? Well, we'll see what we can find to get those creative juices flowing.
Hey, Cinnamon Bun, how's this for inspiration?
Flame Princess! Yes, she inspires me to be better. Hang on. All done. Here's my note.
Gotta hand it to him. CB's a fast writer when he's inspired.
Thanks, Cinnamon Bun. Now we have to talk to some more people in the kingdom. I don't think two thank you notes will be enough to boost Flame Princess's confidence.
Oh, that reminds me. I have this stack of thank you notes that I've been meaning to give to the princess.
You mean people have already been writing her thank you notes?
Oh yeah, for months and months. The people like her way better than her mean old father. I just keep forgetting to give them to her.
Would have been nice to know that before. Never mind. Thanks, Cinnamon Bun. You've been a real help.
No problem, Finn. See you later!
Yeah!
Nice!
Hey, Flame Princess, check these out!
Thank you notes! Hundreds of them, from people all over the Fire Kingdom!
See? You don't have to worry. People think you're an awesome leader.
Wow! I guess so.
So, how about it? Wanna come and play keyboard in our band?
Please?
Well, I guess if I can do such a good job ruling the Fire Kingdom, playing the keyboard again after all these years should be a snap. Sure, I'll do it.
Awesome! We're meeting at the treehouse in a little while. We'll see you there.
Where are you going now?
To the forest. We have a singer to recruit. Aw, man. Looks like Lumpy Space Princess is living in the woods again. She's not gonna be happy with us.
It's gonna be tough to talk LSP into singing for our band. What with us getting her kicked out of the Ice Kingdom and all.
Hey, LSP. How's it going?
How's it going? How do you think it's going? Thanks to you, instead of running my own kingdom with my prince at my side, I'm back living in the Lumpin' Woods.
Prince? What prince?
None of your business, Jake. Now why are you guys bugging me?
Well, we, See, we're putting together a band to record my favorite record, and we're hoping maybe you'd help us out and be our singer?
Your singer? You have some serious lumps asking me to help you after all you did to me! No way!
Yeah, well, we're sorry about that. But you see, it's...
Your fans! It's your fans, LSP! They are demanding a performance!
They are?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they are! They totally are!
Oh my glob, I have fans? What am I saying? Of course I have fans! I probably have, like, a whole lumpin' fan club.
Absolutely you do!
She does?
Mm-hmm!
Yeah, you totally do!
Okay, I can't let my fans down. You get them all together, and I'll make the big announcement of my comeback tour. But I'm not doing this for you! I'm doing it for them! You lumpin', got me?
Yeah, totally!
Okay, you should gather all of my fans in the tree stump clearing in a little while when everyone is ready. I'll make my big announcement then. Oh my god, this is so exciting!
See? She's totally on board. Easy peasy.
Yeah, except for the part where LSP doesn't actually have a fan club.
Guess we'll just have to convince a couple of people to pretend to be fans. I'm sure we can handle that. We've been through a lot worse today.
I can't untie the rope. The knots are too tight. That's not working. It's too far to reach.
I got it! That was easy.
Dig with my hands? No way! That's what shovels or gardening spades are for. That won't work. Hi, tree stump. How's it going?
You again. You already ripped the flower off my head and turned me into a cannibal by making me eat apple pie. What now? I mean, seriously, bro. There's pretty much no other horrible thing you could do to me at this point.
We just want you to pretend to be a fan of Lumpy Space Princess's singing.
What? And I was wrong. You heard LSP sing? That's like a horrifying prospect.
But...
Seriously, you got any more apple pie? Because I'd rather be a cannibal.
No, you don't have to listen to her sing. You just have to pretend you're a fan and you want to hear her sing.
Yeah, the singing will happen somewhere else, we promise.
That's okay, I guess. But there's still all the nasty stuff you did to me. Especially the flower. I love that flower and you ripped it right off. I mean, those things don't grow on trees, man. Well, I guess they do, but you know what I mean.
What about if we made it up to you somehow? Did something nice for you? Then would you help us?
I guess so. But it would have to be really nice. Not make me throw up.
Deal. We'll figure something out. And we'll do it quick. LSP is going to be here any minute.
Seriously? You set this up before you even asked me? I gotta tell you, bro. You're not off to a good start on the whole doing something nice thing. I'm gonna boo her so bad if you screw up. Like, seriously bad. You won't believe it.
No need for that. We'll do something really nice for you, promise. Now you just stay here. We'll be back soon.
I'll be rooted to this spot. Ha ha ha, get it? Cause I'm a... Nah, never mind, just go.
I should probably ask Tree Trunks before I take her gardening spade.
You should really ask permission before you take any of Tree Trunk's flowers.
Well, hello, boys. Nice to see you again.
Hi, Tree Trunks. Sorry to bother you, but we need your help.
Oh, it's never bother, Finn. You boys are always there for me, so I'm always here for you. What can I do for you?
Do you think think we could borrow your gardening spade for a little while?
Why, that would be just fine. I just planted some brand new flower seedlings this morning, but I'm done gardening now.
Would it be okay if we took one of your flower seedlings?
I suppose that would be fine. Just make sure you plant it in a pot or something with a good handful of dirt, and it should grow up nice and pretty for you.
So, tree trunks. You know Lumpy Space Princess?
Oh, yeah. I don't really much care for her. Truth be told, she really can run off at the mouth something fierce. And always being so mean and nasty to people.
Yeah, that's her all right.
See, we need LSP to be the singer in this band we're putting together to re-record my favorite record. We kind of told her she had a fan club, only she doesn't, so we need people to pretend to be your fans.
Well, you boys are always doing stuff for me when I need help. I guess the least I can do is pretend to like Lucky Spice Princess singing for a little bit. I mean, how bad could it be anyway?
Best not to dwell on that.
Cool. Thanks for helping us out, Tree Trunks. We'll see you when we have the rest of the fake fan club together. We'll meet you at the tree stump clearing later.
All right, boys. See you later.
You're gonna have to plant that seedling in something so it doesn't die off. Sure was nice of Tree Trunks to let you borrow her gardening spade. Good digging. That's some nice dirt you got there, dude.
What? Why? You think if you put a handful of dirt on my head, a flower is just gonna grow out of it on its own? Try again. Hey, pretty flower. And in a day, with nothing to grow in, it'll be a dead flower. Dead flower on my head! Yay! Not.
I think the dirt has to be in some kind of container for that to work, Finn.
I can't untie the rope. The knots are too tight.
Quit messing with that. Nice. Bucket and some rope. I'm sure nobody was using that well anyway. Actually, I don't know why you weren't carrying the dirt in the bucket the whole time.
Might not be a real flower pot, but I'm sure the seedling will grow to a big, beautiful flower in there.
Nice fishing pole, dude! Well, those things can't be combined.
There you go, tree stump. What do you think?
Oh, yay! It's a... Oh, wait. That's actually pretty nice. Wow, thanks.
So, are we good? Will you pretend to be a groupie?
Why not? I got a pretty flower on my head again. It's all good.
Great, because here they come.
Ben. Ben. Lumpen introduced me.
Right. Ladies and, elephants and tree stumps, here to announce her comeback tour, I give you... Lumpy Space Princess!
Yay, Lucky Spice Princess, woo!
Yeah, woo! All right.
Oh, my glob! Thank you! Thank you, everybody, so much!
You think she notices she only has two fans?
Shh!
Well, like you said, spoiler alert, by the way, Ben. I'm announcing my comeback tour. I'll be doing a private recording session today, but I'll have my tour dates and my new album release really, really soon.
Yay!
Whoa.
And, what the heck, since you're my most loyal fans, you all get a copy of my album!
Or a discounted price autograph extra.
Yay!
Whoa.
Sorry to cut this short, but I gotta run off to my recording session. You guys are great. Bye!
Yay.
Whoa! Phew.
Wow! I can't believe that actually worked!
Well, me and Jacob gotta run. We have a record to make. Thanks a lot, ladies!
Bye, everybody!
Yeah! Bye, everybody! Of course.
You snagged it, dude! PB's gonna be happy to get that back, even if it is covered in nasty cave water.
Thank you for finding all my missing outfits, Finn. After I have everything re-cleaned, I can finally change out of this old dress. Sorry to put you guys through all that trouble.
Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
And what we gotta do now is make a record.
Yeah, boy! Is everything ready?
All the equipment is set, and everybody's on the way to the treehouse. We're good to go. Then I guess it's recording time. Okay, Finn. You ready for this?
Totally. Let's do it.
Hey, everybody. Everybody. Hey, quiet. Hey.
Quiet.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. We're ready to start. Reel to reel on.
Reel to reel on.
Turntable to maximum spin.
Roger that.
Band ready.
Keyboards ready.
Ready on the skins.
Oh, I'm so flippin' ready.
What about Lemon Grab?
I got this. Hey, Lemon Grab! Lemon Hope is, hiding in the microphone. He's gonna jump out as soon as the music starts. Better be ready.
I will strike him down with my sound sword as soon as the first notes of the horrid music are played.
He's ready.
Okay, everybody. This is it. Remember, put all of your emotions into this. We gotta fix Finn's favorite record. This one's going out to Finn and Jake Investigations. We go in 3, 2, 1, and play! And cut! Thanks, guys. That's a wrap. We got what we need.
We were lumping awesome!
Oh, that was totally hot.
We were rocking out, man!
BMO was helping. Yay, BMO!
Lemon Hope is not here. Unacceptable!
What are they talking about? That was awful!
Yeah, that was nothing like my record. It was a disaster.
No way, it was exactly right. You guys forget we're using magical recording equipment. Just listen. Hey, BMO, play that record.
Yay, finally! Dance party!
Told ya.
Yeah!
All right!
Boy, did we have some adventures. And it took a lot longer than it usually takes. But all in all, I'd say the first cases of Finn and Jake Investigations were a success.
You said it, man. We should do this again sometime. But not right now. There's only one thing I want to do right now.
What's that, buddy?
Dance, boy!
I'm a tough baby that can dance like a man. I can shake him up, Benny, I can shake him again. I'm a tough tootin' baby, I can punch it.
Well, wasn't that a lot of fun? We should play both the Grables more often instead of just watching them. Grable Babel Grapes. Playing those Grables was as exciting as when Finn and Jake fought the giant mushroom with Billy's girlfriend, Canyon. I hope you were paying attention. 'Cause it's time to guess the theme. I know the playable Grables are a lot longer, Mabel, than our normal stories, so we'll take a few Clables to talk through your answer. What was the theme for our five playable Grables? Good job. You got that on the first try. That's right. The theme of the playable Grables was the five most powerful emotions. Fear, envy, anger, sadness, and love. The silly wizard guy was afraid he'd spend his whole life in the candy prison. The blue guy got to stay with Finn and Jake again, but he was envious that Finn and Jake had such a nice place to live. Lemon Grab said that the pranks that Finn and Jake played on him this time made him angry. Worse than when he was ruling the Candy Kingdom and when Finn made his pudding all fizzyable at the lemon dinner. The sword that Cinnamon Bun bought was supposed to make him happy, but it caused him nothing but grief after he bought it. And Finn had to find a way to fix the record his parents used to play for him because he loved it. Good job! That's it for this time, but maybe we'll play Mabel together again soon. Until then, though, I'll see you crimpy glimmers on Triode Flimpin' the Diode.